WWE presents Unforgiven.
Welcome everyone to WWE Unforgiven live here on the WWE Network here in Anaheim, California. I am Boy123Jim. Hit the like button, subscribe for more fun of me on Twitter at Boy123Jim. I hope you guys would enjoy today's pay-per-view. Without further ado, let's get this show started. Yeah, what a way to kick off the WWE Unforgiven pay-per-view with the United States Championship on the line.
From Montreal, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 205 pounds, Sami Zayn,
former television champion, heading into this match for the United States Championship. This could be Sami Zayn's first time winning the U.S. title here tonight. Sami Zayn invoking his rematch calls after losing the belt at a Night of Champions last month in Detroit, Michigan. If tonight's show will be epic. So now we have that Tornado Hell in the Cell match. We have the WWE Championship match in the Hell in the Cell. We have a lot of things going on. And who could forget the World Heavyweight Championship inside of a steel cage between The Rock and Brock Lesnar. But here comes Prince Pretty, the United States Champion.
From seasonal residency, weighing in at 206 pounds, he is the United States Champion, Tyler Breeze.
Tyler Breeze, former two-time, former two-time United States Champion, but current champion right now, actually. Tyler Breeze heading into his second ladder match. This was the same concept that he won the U.S. title from Dolph Ziggler. Now looking to go up and retain the championship against Sami Zayn here tonight in Anaheim. Both men from NXT came up to the main roster. Now both men are fighting for the United States Championship. That's what it's all about. The WWE United States Championship. This whole thing started with Tyler Breeze ever since he became number one contender. Wait a minute, Sami Zayn! Nice maneuver dropping Breeze face to body first. And wait a minute. Oh, Tyler Breeze with a nice double leg takedown. This all started when Tyler Breeze won a Battle Royale to become number one contender for then Dolph Ziggler's United States Championship. And after he lost to Dolph Ziggler at Money in the Bank, then after they had a rematch at Extreme Backlash, Tyler Breeze won the championship in a ladder match. And then after that, Tyler Breeze lost the belt to Dolph Ziggler, but then won the championship from Sami Zayn. I mean, Tyler Breeze has been on a reign of winning championship gold. I mean, former television champion and now current United States, two-time United States champion. As well, I mean, oh, Tyler Breeze with a nice counter, nice arm drag. Tyler Breeze has Sami Zayn got him by the arm. And now, wait a minute. Oh, Zayn. Look at Zayn. Nice to be able to counter and get out of that arm-wrenching hold by Tyler Breeze. And now Zayn, nice snapmare. And now, oh, elbow to the back of the head of Tyler Breeze. Going to kick to the arm there by Sami Zayn. Oh, going for a shot. But Tyler Breeze with a shot to the face. Both men are just fighting it out in the middle of the ring. But the whole point is, you got to get the ladder to climb up and get that championship. As Breeze went flying with Zayn with a nice suplex and a nice running dropkick to follow it up.
Wow, he's still down after that.
The fans were shocked when Tyler Breeze was able to defeat Sami Zayn as he was, again! Nice half Nelson suplex there Sami Zayn onto Breeze. The fans were shocked when Breeze was able to defeat Sami Zayn, even though Sami Zayn was on the roll of being television champion. Defeated Neville in 2 5-star matches. Defeated Daniel Bryan in a 5-star match at SummerSlam, in my opinion. And then now, all of a sudden, he fights Tyler Breeze and he loses. And now Zayn using the ladder as a weapon, obviously, attacking the leg of Breeze, but that didn't affect him that much, as Breeze with a nice hurricanrana. And now, nice shoulder tackle there. Short arm shoulder tackle by Sami Zayn. And now, Breeze. Looking to get back into the match. Looking not let Sami Zayn's momentum rise up as this match goes on. Nice elbow drop by Breeze. And now Breeze, looking to do something with the legs of Sami Zayn, but Zayn. Not going to let that happen. Now Zayn. Has Breeze. Only treats. And now, wait a minute, Zayn attacking the left arm. Now, Sami Zayn has Breeze. Kicks in the midsection. DDT! Taking a DDT him onto the ladder. And now, Zayn, Irish whipping into the corner. Nice way to kick off the pay per view with the United States Championship on the line in a ladder match. Breeze up top, and a nice elbow to the skull of Sami Zayn. And now Breeze looking to go for a super bottle kick, but Sami Zayn caught Breeze with a snapmare. And now elbow shots with the leg lock. Elbow shots to the skull, and I think Breeze might be busted open, and he is. And now Sami Zayn going up top already. Will Zayn become a United States champion for the first time? Will Sami Zayn achieve redemption? Will Sami Zayn win the U.S. title? Breeze up. Breeze is up. And he got Zayn down. Go for a supermodel kick again. But Zayn taking Breeze up to the outside. Zayn up top. Zayn up top. Breeze is watching. Breeze is watching, and Zayn got the title. Sami Zayn got the championship. Sami Zayn is the United States champion. It was too late for Breeze, but Sami Zayn able to achieve redemption. Sami Zayn able to win the United States championship for the first time in his career. Able to climb the ladder and retrieve the championship.
What a ladder match.
Sami Zayn is the winner of this match. Well, ladies and gentlemen, but coming up next, Paige versus Alicia Fox for the Women's Championship. Paige defeated Naomi in a steel cage match to get to where she's at right now to fight Alicia Fox for the Women's title. And it's going to happen. Coming up right now. And here we go. Live in Anaheim.
The following contest is scheduled for pinfall, and it is for the WWE Women's Championship.
WWE Women's Championship is on the line. Former Women's Champion Paige. Paige, former 2-time Divas Champion, and also former Women's Champion. Last time Paige was Women's Champion was back at SummerSlam, where she lost at SummerSlam pre-show, where she lost to Naomi, and then she went to Detroit in a triple threat between Naomi and Alicia Fox for the Women's title, and And Alicia Fox was able to get the win and pin Paige, by the way. And here comes the WWE Women's Champion. Alicia Fox is the second, the second African American WWE Women's Champion. The first one was Miss Jacqueline, WWE Hall of Famer. But anyways, Paige goes one on one against Alicia Fox for the women's title. Alicia Fox is able to get the win back in that championship, that triple threat for the women's title. And Paige has a scratch and claw, defeating Naomi in a tough match, a tough steel cage match for that very women's championship. Will Paige be able to get the championship, or will Alicia Fox continue her reign as champ? Let's go find that out right now. Let's go. The matchup is underway, and here we go. Oh, go for a drop kick to Alicia Fox, but Paige got her in the collarbone tie-up. Got her by the arm now, does Paige. And now, oh, Paige. Wrenching the arm, twerking it very much. Now Paige looking to get Alicia Fox down to one knee. Still got her arm wrapped around Alicia Fox's left arm, and oh, putting pressure on it. And now Carter will tie up once again, headlock. And now wait, Paige pushing Alicia Fox to the ropes. Although she goes in a drop kick by Alicia Fox there. Now Alicia Fox Irish surfing Paige off the ropes. And a nice total world sidewalk slam. Nice maneuver there by Alicia Fox. But can she capitalize? No way, Paige. Nice uppercut to follow to get back into the match. Kick to the midsection. And now wait, Paige. Head match slam does Paige onto Alicia Fox. Nice elbow shot to the face there. And now wait a minute, Paige. Side rush and leg sweep. Nice shot to the back there, and now Paige. Oh, vicious headbutt to their first ever African-American WWE Divas champion. And no wait. Oh, nice shot to the head there by Alicia Fox. Kick to the knee. Oh, shining wizard there by Alicia Fox. And a boot to the side of the face there by Paige. And now Alicia Fox got her in the headlock. And now, oh, drop her. Man. Paige able to drop. Oh, wait. Alicia Fox. Back and forth they go in this match. And now, wait. Alicia with a DDT. And now, oh, attacking the right arm of Paige. It would be smart to take away Paige. It would be smart of Alicia to attack on Paige's arms because, well, Paige, you know, the PTO and the Rampage and the Paige Turner, mostly Paige using all of her finishing maneuvers with her arms. So it would be smart to take away her arms in a way that it would kind of hurt her if she did those moves. Nice maneuver there. Back suplex. First cover of the match. Shoulders are down. Two count. What you got in the kick out? And two does Alicia. And now Alicia Fox. Oh, no, Paige. Got her in the front headlock. Dragging into the middle of the ring. And now Paige. Oh! Nice jawbreaker there. Literally have to sit down to make the move more effective. And now, wait a minute, Paige. Paige, here we go. Paige Turner. The Paige Turner. Cover. Hooks the leg. Slows it down. Will she become a two-time women's champion? A kick out of two. Does Alicia. Paige can't believe that she kicked out of the Paige Turner. But it would be smart if Paige hit the Rampage right there. Maybe it might end Alicia Fox's title reign. But wait a minute. Paige has something in mind. Tossing Alicia onto the outside. Wait, we saw this on Monday. Paige had to go for a suicide dive, but Charlotte caught her. Will Alicia Fox catch her this time? No, wait. And oh, suicide dive through the second rope. That's what it means to become women's champions for Paige. Oh, a shot there, Alicia Fox. They're gonna get back into it, bringing Paige back inside the ring, elbow to the tip, to the forehead of Paige and a leg drop to follow it up. Alicia Fox looking to do whatever it takes to retain that championship. But Paige looking to do whatever it takes, risking her own health, risking her own body to win that championship. Nice somersault leg drop there. Or front flip leg drop by Alicia Fox. Cover. Will that do it? Will that put away Paige in the kick at it too? Ooh, knee to the spine. Directly to the spine of Paige. Man, that's gotta hurt. And now Alicia Fox looking to take out Paige. Bringing her to the outside. Remember, Paige can only win by pinfall or submission. Count out disqualification will not mean a thing. We're, as a result of changing the having the title change hands. Nice vicious headbutts by Paige. As both women fighting on the outside, running hurricanrana. Paige with a running hurricanrana. By the way, Alicia Fox countered that elbow. Alicia, driving her right into the barricade. Now follow off with a side wrestling leg sweep. Alicia Fox looking to get back inside the ring. Alicia back inside the ring. Look at the break, the count. Got back inside. Oh my God! A kick to the side of the head by Alicia Fox, and another running drop kick this time, directly to the chest of Paige. Now, a DDT onto the floor. Alicia Fox looking to do damage on the Paige on the outside. Maybe so she won't be able to get back inside the ring for a count out. Who knows? Maybe Alicia Fox was able to break the count the last time. Looks like she wasn't going to do it this time. But Paige was able to get back inside the ring. Kicked in the midsection. Paige is something in mind here. Paige. Ooh. I thought she was going to go for a side rush and leg sweep. But she got it with a nice inverted backbreaker there. And now wait a minute. Wait a minute, Paige. Gonna try it again. Paige Turner. The Paige Turner. Cover. Will I win the championship? The same move that won the title years ago. The kick out. A shoulder up by Alicia. I was gonna say that Paige Turner was the same move that she beat AJ Lee with the night after WrestleMania one time and become the Divas Champion. Here's a girl in Paige that was told she wasn't pretty enough to be a WWE Diva. Paige used the Rampage to defeat Brie Bella for the Women's Championship a couple of months back here in Uterus Mode. Alicia Fox still staying alive, not looking to give up. Alicia Fox looking to take a breather, but that might come back to haunt her. Elbow shot to the face by Paige, forearm to the face by Alicia. Now Alicia Fox got her. Northern Lights suplex, beautiful cover. Shoulders to down. Does she have it on a kick out of two of those Paige? Both women looking to inflict a lot of punishment on one another. Looking to go off the deep end. Doing whatever it takes to win. Forearm to the face. Kicks back and forth. And now Paige. Something in mind here. I don't know what she's going for. Paige is up top. Paige, wait a minute. Paige, what the hell? Oh my God! Hurricanrana from the top! Hurricanrana from the top! And she goes for the cover! What that doing? Hooks the leg! Will we have a new women's champion? We do! Paige, able to get the win. Nasty Hurricanrana from the top. Paige is the winner.
Here are your winners and new WWE Women's Champion, Paige.
Paige able to win the championship for the second time in a row this year. Man, what a match. But coming up next, the Tornado Tag Team Extreme Rules match. Winner faces Edge and Christian at Survivor Series for the World Tag Team titles. It's the Usos versus members of the Alliance, and it's going to happen next. Here we go. Live in Anaheim, California, and Unforgiven, and here comes the Sons of Rikishi. The Usos. The Usos, former WWE Tag Team Champions back in 2014, held the championship from March all the way to December. All the way to November, I should say. Or no. All the way up to September, I should say. To go to Stardust at the time. Not looking to go back for championship gold. As Ian Sear are not competing tonight. Neither are the Young Bucks.
The following Tornado Tag Team Contest is an Extreme Rules match. On the way to the ring, Jimmy Uso and Jay Uso. The Uso.
The Uso brothers, the sons of Rikishi, WWE Hall of Famer. Looking to get themselves some championships in Universe Mode. And so are these guys. The Alliance. As you guys can see, Bodas is still not with him. Bodas is still a little hurt after what Neville did to him on main event weeks ago. But nothing less. This is a tag team Extreme Rules match, Tornado style. The winner faces Edge and Christian at Survivor Series for the World Tag Team Championships. So this is basically like a number one contenders match, if you will. But, well, plus these guys have been going at it back and forth, and now tonight, they get to go at it now. They get, maybe they might end the feud. Who knows? And now, oh. Nice elbow to the face there by Heath. As his matchup is on the way. You don't know what's going to happen there. All four men are in the ring. Wait, Heath Slater taking, I believe, Jay Uso onto the outside. Jimmy Uso's with Curtis Axel. I believe this past SmackDown. Last week. Not this past week on SmackDown. Last week on SmackDown. I believe Jimmy Uso fought Curtis Axel and Jey Uso fought Heath Slater. Jey Uso was able to defeat Heath Slater, but Jimmy Uso was able to lose to Curtis Axel. Curtis Axel able to get the win off of Jimmy Uso on SmackDown last week. And now it's kind of dangerous here because you never know. One pinfall in the ring, one submission, it's over. So you never know who will tap out, who will get pinned. You never know what's gonna happen. Tornado style Extreme Rules weapons are involved. Obviously, there is no disqualifications, no countouts. Heath Slater is going to town on Jey Uso on the outside. Jimmy Uso suffering a back body drop, and now wait, Curtis Axel might have heard what I just said. Going after a weapon now. Got a kendo stick. Oh, shot to the face of Jimmy Uso. Now Axel going to town with that kendo stick to the skull. But it's Axel. He said looking to become number one contenders for the World Tag Team titles. After Curtis Axel and Heath Slater have been on the roll lately, you know. They want six-man tags. They've been winning tag team matches. And after they've won one-on-one singles competition. So maybe tag team championships might be in their future. Heath Slater up top. Leg drop. As Jimmy Uso face first into the post. Shoulders are down. Would have put away Jey Uso to kick out. And now Axel, they're going to bring Jimmy into the ring. Heath Slater, Irish whipping Jay into the corner. Boot to the face there by Jay, onto Heath. Now Axel, snapmare. And now, attacking the head and neck area. That's another nice Michinoku driver by Jay Uso. Covered by Axel, and a kick at a two. And now Slater. They're going to fight back against Jimmy. Jay. Cover. Shoulders are down. Kick at a two. And now, Jimmy Uso has something in mind. Heath Slater has Jay. Forward. Russian leg sweep. And now an elbow drop to follow it up as Jimmy Uso tosses the axe onto the outside.
Pretty odd for a guy who fancies himself as a one-man band.
Of course he's a one-man band, Michael.
And now Axel. No, wait. Axel and Jay playing mind games there. And now wait. Axel. Double legs. Takedown. And Slater dropping Jay. Cover. Hooks the leg. Will that win in the tag team title? No. Kick out of two. Will that win in the tag team title match, though? But Axel. Face first goes Jimmy. Cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. Will it be? Axel Mania running wild once again. Axel and he able to get the win here tonight at Unforgiven. Curtis Axel, Heath Slater, been successful as a tag team. This might have been the best thing that ever happened to their careers. Winning some tag team matches, now they're they are the number one contenders for the World Tag Team Championship. Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, the Divas title on the line, Emma versus Nikki Bella, and it's going to come up right now. And here we go.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the WWE Divas Championship.
And here we go, the WWE Divas Championship is on the line, the new attitude of Emma versus Nikki Bella. As Emma makes her way down the aisle, winning a ladder match, defeating Cameron. But before that, defeated, I believe, Summer Rae. Yeah, she defeated Summer Rae to get to face Cameron the next week, which she defeated Cameron in a ladder match to become number one contender. But can Emma win the championship here tonight? Emma, I know she's focused on this match. There's always the WWE Divas Champion. Nikki Bella been Divas Champion ever since defeating Natalya back at SummerSlam, Madison Square Garden. And ever since then, she's been defending the championship. She's been champion for over a month now. Will she retain the championship, or will we have a new Divas champion? We have a new women's champion in Paige. Will Emma be the second new champion, the third new champion here tonight? Emma versus Nikki Bella. And here we go, the bell has rung, and oh, Nikki Bella with a forearm to the face in the early going of the match. And now Nikki, looking to be on the offense in this matchup already. Oh, face first goes Emma. And now Nikki's looking to go something huge. Oh, nice drop to a hold there by Emma, dropping the champion. And now, oh, Emma has the champion. And now Emma tossing Nikki, just having a nice grip on her hair. Nice shot to the back there. And now Emma bringing Nikki's head all the way down to the mat. And now Emma, single knee, camel clutch on the champion. Will she tap in the early going? No way. Nikki Bell had a phenomenal matchup against Natalya this past episode on SmackDown. Oh, a nice DDT by Emma. If you have not checked out SmackDown and Monday Night Raw this past week, the link will be in the description box below. A shot to the gut there by Nikki. Oh, and a headmatch slam by the champ. Back and forth they go in this match. And now Nikki has Emma snap suplex. Beautiful snap suplex by the champion. As Nikki has something in mind as the champion.
What, are we gonna see here?
What a nice back suplex. As Nikki looking to stay on the offense here. Attacking the head and neck area of Emma. And now looking to do something else.
As you alluded to earlier, King,
Try headlock and now, oh, a nice fireman's carry there by Nikki. Yeah, she goes for the cover. Shoulders it down. Kick. Does she have her there? Two count. She got her in the kick out. Emma's able to kick out at two. Emma has to fight her way. She has to fight, scratch, claw for a way for her to get to this spot right now. Able to counter that nasty form by Nikki. And nice nightmare to a big boom to the face by Emma. And now Nikki has Emma. Has something in mind. The champion got Emma. The champion has the challenger on the top. And a nice arm drag. Tossing her across the ring. Goes for the cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. Will it be? Two count on the kick out by Emma. As Nikki Bella. The champion. Who's been champion over a month. Having the challenger where she wants her. Now Nikki. Oh wait. Oh, vicious DDT to the leg. And now, Nikki Bella, oh, grabbing Emma by the neck and just dropped her. And now that nasty form in the face. Cover, would have put away Emma here. Two count, she got her in a kick out of two, does Emma. Nikki can't believe that Emma kicked out of that nasty form. Now Nikki has Emma, front headlock, doing damage. Oh, kick to the midsection. Now, Nikki got her again. And now, oh, wait a minute. Oh, dragon screw. By the champion. Kick to the midsection. And now, wait. Nikki sizing up Emma. Kick to the gut once again. Emma has to fight her way to where she's at right now. Able to win the ladder match to gain her, to get her shot for the Divas title. But it might come to an end here. The rack attack. The rack attack, maybe that could do it. Who knows? Cover, hooks the leg, shoulders it down. Will it be? She got her neck, shoulder up by Emma. Emma was able to get the shoulder up, not letting Nikki, letting her opportunity go by. Nikki Bella was able to get a nice win over Natalya this past Wednesday night on SmackDown with a roll-up, and I won't be surprised if she tried to do the roll-up here tonight. And Unforgiven ramming Emma shoulder first right into the post, and now driving her knee into the face of Emma. And they got her by the leg. Oh, an attack in the left leg of Emma. And now, oh, and a nasty clothesline dropping Emma. Has Nikki been on the offense for at least over 5-plus minutes now in this match? Nice form to the face there by Emma. Emma trying to fight back, but the champion has her number so far. I was whipping her right into the corner. Elbow to the face by Emma. And now Emma running drop kick to the knee. Even though Nikki has been working on the knee. Wait a minute. Emma might be going for the Emma lock. She got her locked in. The Emma lock is locked in. Will a champ tap out? Wait. No. Probably did damage. Maybe that could do it. Hooks, goes for the cover. Form in the face. Shoots the hat. Two count and a shoulder up. Right shoulder up by Nikki. Emma had her hopes up, but she gotta keep fighting. Oh, backstabber. Beautiful backstabber. Shaped of former WWE superstar Carlito. And also former WWE superstar Alberto Del Rio. Nice stomp to the face there by Emma. Tremendous action here. And Unforgiven attacking the right arm of the champ. With our snapmare or a DDT, but no counter. Side rushing leg sweep. And now, oh, the elbow. No way. She counter. She was able to move out the way. Now Emma has Nikki. Got her up on the top rope. Emma back suplex. Nikki landed on her, the back of her neck. Shoots the half form in the face. Will she become a two-time? Not a kick out of two. That's Nikki able to get the shoulder up. The right shoulder. I was going to say, will Emma become a two-time Divas champion? Have a slip off the ropes. Or if we got to get out the way. Nice clothesline. Taking on the champion. Emma building up some steam here. Building up momentum. But Nikki looking to shut it down. And a clothesline to the outside. Emma cannot win by pin, by count out or disqualification. Got to get in the ring for pinfall and submission. Nikki, the champ, wants to pin the challenger. And DDT. The champion looks to beat the challenger in the ring, actually. Not letting the referee count the 10. But now, Nikki, looking to set it up. Oh my gosh, she got her. She got her on the shoulders. Would a championship match be over? Torture rack or rack attack? I keep mixing it up. The rack attack. Cover. Would that be 2? She got her. Still champion is Nikki Bella. Nikki Bella is the first champion to retain her championship here tonight. As the fans here in Anaheim going berserk for Nikki Bella retaining her championship in a nice, awesome match against Emma. Kudos to both divas. But in the end, Nikki Bella able to retain the WWE Divas Championship. Now Nikki Bella looking to celebrate her retaining the championship. But coming up next, the Intercontinental Championship will be in a no-holds-barred match. Cesaro became number one contender after winning a fatal four-way match a couple weeks back on Raw versus Kevin Owens for the Intercontinental title. And it's happening right now.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match, and it is for the Intercontinental Championship.
Intercontinental Championship on the line. Cesaro, former two-time tag team champion with Tyson Kidd, former United States champion, but never really held the Intercontinental Championship before. Cesaro, well, last time he fought Kevin Owens was in a ladder match at Money in the Bank. Cesaro was close. He had the championship right in his hands. He had the title belt right in his hands, but then Kevin Owens, like a cat, just came up, knocked Cesaro off the ladder, and was able to retrieve the championship. But not tonight. You have to win by pinfall and or submission. Can Cesaro finally do it and win the Intercontinental Championship? And there comes the Intercontinental Champion.
This place is coming alive now. Man, oh man, this guy's about to get booed out of the building.
A man that held the belt from Payback, all the way from winning the championship back at Payback in Sacramento. And it held the belt ever since. Ever since then, all the way till SummerSlam. Lost the belt to Samoa Joe. Then won back the championship back in Night of Champions. And then brought back the old, from 1998 to 2011, Intercontinental Championship. Kevin Owens just came here to do business. And here we go.
Introducing the challenger from Lucerne, Switzerland, weighing in at 232 pounds, Cesaro.
Nice reception for Cesaro.
And his opponent from Marieville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion,
decent reception for Kevin Owens, but it's all for that very championship belt, that Intercontinental title. Can Cesaro finally do it and beat Kevin Owens for that Intercontinental Championship? Or Kevin Owens' reign probably might continue. Or, like, I don't know, like, his new reign continue. That's what I'm trying to say here. But there we go. Matchup is underway. Bell's rung. No holds barred. Cesaro shot after shot to the face of Owens. Got a little tie up, and now Cesaro has Kevin Owens right in the corner there. And, oh, Kevin Owens shot to the face, giving Cesaro a little payback after what happened early in the matchup. Now Cesaro has Kevin Owens front headlock. And now Cesaro underhook suplex there. And now, oh, a double foot stomp to follow it up. And a kick to the side of Owens. As Cesaro has Owens. Irish whip off the rough back body drop. The champion going flying, but oh, the champ trying to get back into early in the early going. And now Owens on the outside. Looking to take a breather, but Cesaro not letting it happen. Cesaro, here we go, back suplex onto the floor. Cesaro not letting this opportunity go by, looking to do whatever it takes to win as Kevin Owens. Nice neck breaker there. And now Owens, looking to take a part of that steel steps. Looking to use it on Kevin Owens. Oh, Kevin Owens using the steps onto Cesaro. Face first again. Kevin Owens using the steps, obviously as a weapon. Using it to his full advantage. Oh man, Cesaro tripping over the bottom part of the steel steps. Remember, the Intercontinental Championship's on the line. Now Owens looking to do damage from the cranium, the skull of Cesaro there. And now Cesaro! Ever since Cesaro returned to the title picture, Cesaro told me that he's gonna do whatever it takes to win. Cesaro in trouble, go for a German to Owens, but Cesaro with an elbow, oh, that boot to the face, a boot to the skull there. And then Cesaro looking to rile up the crowd, and now, oh, right onto the barrier, go for the belly, but Owens ricking the eyes. Not Kevin Owens. Kevin Owens, oh, what a suplex by Kevin Owens. Head first onto the bottom of the steel steps. And oh wait, oh my god. Cesaro landing on his neck.
And Cesaro's starting to really turn things up here. When you're as powerful and innovative as Cesaro, you can turn it up in there as easy as a regular person walking into their living room.
Kevin Owens tripping over the steel steps. There's both men fighting on the outside. They gotta be inside the ring if they want to finish the match, though. But look like they want to do a lot of damage to each other. Cesaro using the steel steps. Payback or hell. And Cesaro using the steps to his full advantage. And now Kevin Owens looking to go for a shot to the face. Cesaro blocking it. Kick to the midsection. Shot to the face. Front headlock. And now got him. Cesaro got Kevin Owens now. Oh, boot to the chest there. And oh, a boot to the side of the head. And Cesaro has given Kevin Owens a boot to the face earlier in that. You know, Cesaro has Owens. Now Cesaro has something in mind. This might not end well. Oh, nice form to the face there by Cesaro. Now Cesaro on the second row. Cesaro has something in mind. What is he going for here? Wait a minute. Cesaro! Oh my god! What a beautiful suplex from the apron all the way to inside the ring. Cover. Two count. He got him now with a shoulder up by Owens. Cesaro was able to lift up 40-plus pounder in Kevin Owens from the apron all the way to the inside of the ring. And a sunset flip powerbomb by Owens. Oh my god, kicked in the midsection by Owens. Owens, looking to go for something huge here. Maybe the package. Powerbomb. And he goes for the cover. Hooks the leg, shoulders it down. Will he retain the championship? Here in the kick out by Cesaro. Man, this, whew, great matchup, making me mess up my voice there. And Cesaro has Owens. Got his arm. Oh! Nice scoop slam. Goes for the cover. Will that do it? Will that put away the champion? Two count. Got him in the shoulder and a kick out. Able to get the shoulder up. Does Owens. I don't know how the hell does Cesaro even hit that suplex from the apron all the way to the middle of the ring. I don't know how. Nice Michinoku driver by Kevin Owens there.
Look how slow he is to recover.
Now Kevin Owens.
That was some serious punishment.
Something in mind there. Kevin Owens. Oh my god. Oh! Springboard elbow to the back and the knee of Cesaro. Both men have suffered from what Kevin Owens just did. And now Cesaro getting up to his feet. Kevin Owens also. Both men are both on their feet now. Cesaro has Kevin Owens. I was up into the corner. And now Cesaro. Has something in mind here. Cesaro on top. Oh my god. What's going on here? What's going on here? Cesaro! Butterfly suplex from the top! Will that do it? Butterfly suplex. Shoulders it down. Will it be? He got him in a kick out of two, as always. Oh my god. What can Cesaro do to put away the champion? Go for a mission. Wait. Oh. Nice exploder suplex there by Cesaro. And Cesaro has Kevin Owens up again. Wait. Cesaro! European uppercut. Cover. Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. Will it be? And it is. Cesaro. Cesaro is the champion. Cesaro is the new Intercontinental Champion. Finally, Cesaro has finally done it. Cesaro is the Intercontinental Champion. What a match by both men, Cesaro and Kevin Owens. But in the end, Cesaro able to get the championship. And now, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, it is time. Tornado Tag Team Hell in a Cell match. This rivalry is finally going to end. It's Seth Rollins, Mr. Money in the Bank, with the game Triple H against Bray Wyatt and Braun Strowman. And this matchup is going to happen, well, you guessed it, right now. Oh. Oh, they're already in the ring. Jeez. I don't know how the hell they do that. They just show up right in the ring. It's ridiculous. And there comes Mr. Money in the Bank, Seth Rollins.
From Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth Rollins.
To my knowledge, I don't believe Seth Rollins has ever competed inside Hell in a Cell in Universe mode. But now tonight, he teams up with the guy who's been in, I believe, in the second most matches in Hell in a Cell history, the game Triple H. Behind the game is The Undertaker. I might be wrong about that. You can let me know in the comments below if I'm right or wrong about it. But Seth Rollins. Not looking to cash in the Money in the Bank as of right now. Looking to end this thing with the Wyatt family. The Wyatt family has been on the thorn of Seth Rollins. And this man, the game Triple H, is backside, if you will. And here comes the game. it might be time to play the game. Triple H, former 15-time world champion, looking to go into another Hell in a Cell match, but this time, I believe this is his first time ever, tornado style, two-on-two tag team, Hell in a Cell, I believe so. Triple H teams up with the guy he had in his authority group last year, but then turned his back on him ever since Rollins became the WWE champion, and then brought back his buddy Batista to be in the group. But now tonight, all history aside, all four men looking to end this once and for all. Seth Rollins, Triple H, Bray Wyatt, Braun Strowman. Who's going to walk out? Who's going to survive Hell in a Cell here at Unforgiven? And here we go. Referee got to ring the bell, and he has. Oh, Rollins after Wyatt and Strowman after the game. This all started when Triple H was beaten up by Braun Strowman after their match on Monday Night Raw. Triple H got injured, then after Rollins got attacked by Braun Strowman when Rollins defeated Bray Wyatt on Monday Night Raw. That's Rollins and, oh, Wyatt blocking that single leg dropkick attempt from Seth Rollins. Now Rollins getting up to his feet, Bray Wyatt on the outside. Rollins going for a dropkick but not able to reach Wyatt. And now Rollins, oh! Bray Wyatt pushing Rollins right into the ring. Another game and Strowman. The meaning of this match is basically all the stuff that happened for the past 2.5 months coming to an end. Rollins. Rollins! Nice moonsault out to Wyatt. Out to the outside. And now Rollins raking the eye of Bray Wyatt and again on Strowman in the game. Oh, and a nasty elbow to the heart of the game. And Wyatt dropping Rollins. The only way to win is by pinfall submission inside the ring. But they're going to beat the hell out of each other before that even happened. And oh, Strowman goes for the cover. Shoulders are down. First cover in the match. Two count. He's having the kick out of the game. And now Rollins tossing Wyatt across all the way to the other side of the cage. Get the blood flowing back in your body and strategize. That's Rollins after he was attacked. After Triple H returned to the Attitude Era version of Monday Night Raw, back I think the night after SummerSlam, when Triple H returned, he said he had one agenda. He had one goal. The reason why he came back is Rollins again with that moveset onto Bray Wyatt once again. And Triple H with a steel chair. Now Rollins go for it again. Oh, but Wyatt dropping Rollins. And now Rollins in the ring. Braun Strowman and Seth Rollins. Oh, back first up to the cage. And Wyatt dropping Triple H's, the chair out of Triple H's hand. Now, oh my god, rubbing Triple H's face on the cage like it was a cheese grater. And I think Rollins bashed or pushed Braun Strowman right into the post there. A lot of actions going on in this match. Strowman driving Rollins back first right into the cage. And Triple H and Wyatt back in the ring. Boot to the face by Triple H. Now Wyatt has Triple H ever up into the corner. And Seth Rollins. And Braun Strowman on the outside. Triple H and Bray Wyatt in the inside of the ring. Oh man, back first and a spine buster to follow it up. And now Triple H cover, hooks the leg, shoulders it down with that put away Wyatt and a kick out of two.
And he gets out of the way.
And now Strowman inflicting punishment on Rollins. Back first into a scoop slam to follow it up. Now Seth Rollins. Oh, a shot to the face. Oh, and Strowman driving Rollins back first, and now Wyatt. Oh, the senton. Senton onto the game. Cover. Hooks the leg. With that put away Triple H. Oh, and a kick out of two. A lot of action going on. A lot of things. Triple H getting up to his feet. And now Braun Strowman. Go for a torque slam. No way. Rollins. And then we'll go for a wheel kick. With a Strowman with a headbutt. And oh wait, head-on collision, and now Rollins with a wheel kick to the face of Strowman, and now Bray Wyatt, and now oh Rollins stopping Wyatt, going for a drop kick, no avail, sees Braun Strowman coming after him, Strowman, and oh wait, Rollins, shot to the face and a knee strike to the head there of Strowman, and now Bray Wyatt, oh my god, shot after shot all over the game. Now Rollins going to the top here. Rollins and a frog splash. Goes for the cover. Hooks the leg. Lateral press. Two count and a kick out by Strowman. A lot of action. Holy. I'm just one man and I'm calling everything. Yeah, Wyatt goes for the cover. So this is down. Two and a kick out. I'm surprised when Seth Rollins leaves the ring that Braun Strowman and Bray Wyatt do not, you know, double team the game for the moment. That'll take you down. Inside the ring again. Yeah, and they should be. This is where the action needs to be. And now Braun Strowman in the ring with Rollins. Oh, got him by his throat, lifting him up. Chump slam. And now wait a minute. As he goes for the cover, Bray Wyatt on top. Back superplex and a kick out by Rollins. Pretty well with a nasty back superplex. Goes for the cover, shoots the hat, form in the face. Shoulders it down with a bayonet kick out by the game. And if you guys see that punch from Rollins earlier, he threw a punch and that didn't do nothing. That didn't phase Braun Strowman. Forms in the face of the better game. Back suplex by Triple H. And oh, face first. By Strowman, and now wait a minute, Rollins has Strowman, oh, superplex, and the cage is busted open, the cage has been broken, they have broken through the cage, and now wait a minute, Triple H, downstairs, pedigree, a pedigree by the game, and now Triple H is going to do damage to the head and neck of Bray Wyatt, Braun Strowman climbing up above us here, climbing up to the top of the cage, thus Rollins, following Braun Strowman, oh my god, oh my god, both men on top of the cage, the last person that was on top of the cage was back earlier this year, the night after Elimination Chamber pay-per-view, The Undertaker fought Batista in the rematch for the WWE Championship. And Batista was last ride off this Hell in the Cell, right through the announce table. And then before that was Mick Foley being tossed off the cage by The Undertaker. And now Rollins side rush to leg sweep. This is very critical and dangerous for both men to be up there. Now Rollins, oh man, flatliner. Now Rollins. And now Strowman. Oh my god. Oh my god. Suplex. Suplex. Oh no. Rollins countered. I thought Strowman was going to suplex Rollins off the cage. Into the table. And a DDT by the game. And now wait. Rollins with a DDT of his own. What a matchup. You don't know what's going to happen here. And a double A spinebuster by the game. And now Rollins flatliner again. Triple H with a spine buster. Cover with that put away. Bray Wyatt with a smash. We over the kick attitude as Wyatt. And Rollins with a kick to the gut. Strowman's on the edge of the cage. And now, oh, Strowman blocking the punch by Rollins. Going for belly to belly suplex. No avail. And now Rollins, oh my god, oh my god! Oh! 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 I think if It's like if Strowman had Rollins, but he walked up. And then, I don't know. Somehow Rollins was not able to fall off the Hell in the Cell onto the announce table.
Has been a war.
You're right about that, Cole.
Kick to the gut there by Rollins. Bray Wyatt in the ring. Doing damage to the game, but the game coming back.
Terrific reversal by Triple H.
Triple H and Bray Wyatt in the ring. Strowman and Rollins on the outside, on top. Wait a minute, Rollins. Wait a minute. Oh my god. Underhook. Oh my god, he went through the cage. He went through the cage. Look at this again. Oh my god. Single underhook facebuster through the cage. Go Strowman. I don't know how the hell.
I can't believe everything that's transpired.
Oh my god.
So physical. You're right about that, Cole. This has been an all-out war.
And now Strowman crawling. I don't know how the hell is he even moving. And now Rollins. Wait a minute. Oh.
The kick out's all that's saving. This match goes on. Wow. What a display of heart and determination.
Maybe Rollins didn't want the match to be over yet, so he had to stop the count. As Strowman has Rollins now into the corner. I don't know how the hell is Braun Strowman even walking?
The frequency of this move,
how is he even moving? That's the question. After what we just seen. Oh my god. Back superplex from the top. And then a back suplex by the game.
Look out.
And now Strowman turns Rollins over, goes for the cover. And now Strowman stops the count. And now the game stopped the count. I don't know why. Critical moment here. Triple H reverse suplex. Single leg drop kick by Rollins. Now Rollins. Wait a minute. Wyatt, and a kick out. Now Rollins. Looking to go back outside. But he sees a double team here. And now wait a minute, Strowman. Choke slam on the game. Cover. Hooks the leg. Would that do it? And Rollins makes the save. And now Wyatt on the hook and toss. What a freaking matchup. And now Strowman reverse suplex onto the game. Into the spine of Rollins. But wait, Strowman. Looking to go for something huge here. Looking to go for his finishing maneover. Wait, no. DDT by the game.
Stay down.
Triple H. Has Strowman. Rollins. Look at the counter. Back suplex. Now Triple H. Goes for the cover. Shoulders it down. Pedigree. Two. And it's over. Triple H. Rollins. Has won the war. The War of the Wyatt Family. It's finally over. Holy goodness. Man, as the cage is going up. What the hell? What's going on? Oh my god! That's the Terminator! Oh my god! The Terminator making his way down the aisle, making his way to the ring. Sunglasses, jackets. Oh my god. And now Terminator getting inside the ring. The game is alone in the ring. Rollins has left the game. Right on the Terminator. What a shot to the face. To Triple H. After a grueling Hell in the Cell match. And now what the hell? Clothesline in the game onto the outside. The Terminator. Arnold Schwarzenegger. What in the world? Oh my god, he got a steel chair. Look at the size of him. Look at the size. He's more bigger than the game himself. Look, he just pushed Triple H away. Oh, and a clothesline. Holy goodness. And now Triple H, look at the fight back. Has Schwarzenegger, has the Terminator. And now the Terminator, oh wait, Triple H. The Terminator goes for a chair. Triple H, standing up tall, standing on the top rope. Oh, double axe handle, the chair went flying. But look at that, he got right up to his feet. You can't keep the man down. Oh my, did you see that punch didn't even faze him? And now, what the? What was he? What's he? Slingshot? Oh! Driving the game down with a suplex. What in the hell? I don't believe what I'm watching. As, oh my god, you got a kendo stick. Look at your arms. You don't really need a goddamn weapon. And oh, the game got a sledgehammer. The game got the sledgehammer. Oh, and a shot to the gut. With the cane. Oh, into the spine. Oh my god. To the spine. To the legs of the game. The Terminator is dominating in this fight. And now, my mic just cut off. The knee to the face of the Schwarzenegger. Oh my god. Oh my god, he got the announce table. He has the announce table. He's taking the stuff off the announce table. I didn't even realize we had a second table. I thought we had one table. Wait a minute. Oh my god, kick to the gut. Another game. Look at it, fight back. Elbow to the face. Triple H, fight back. Elbow to the face again. Of the Schwarzenegger. Of the Terminator. Elbow to the face. One more time. End the game. Look at the new damage. Look at the wear down. Oh no. Jawbreaker. What a fight this is. Oh man. Gut first into the edge of the table. Oh my god, I can't believe this is even happening. I can't put what the, oh my god, no, no, come on, no, 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 oh my god, no, no, a pound driver through the table, pound driver through the table. The Terminator has terminated the game. Oh my god, the Terminator just terminated Triple H. But why? Oh my god, look at the size. This guy is built out of by a machine. It's like, I don't understand. What the hell? The Terminator may have just finished the game. Holy crap. Oh my god. But ladies and gentlemen, time to switch gears, because coming up next, another Hell in the Cell match. But this time it's for the WWE Championship. Dean Ambrose versus Sting. And it's going to happen right now. Oh my god. I can't believe what we witnessed tonight. Oh my god, we have 3 to 4 new champions. The Wyatt family suffered a loss to Triple H and Seth Rollins. And the Terminator just terminated the game. I've never seen anything like that. But now it's time for the WWE Championship match.
Hell in a Cell matches in the past, and I don't expect this one to be any different.
Sting, who's been on a path of destruction, destroying, putting Dean Ambrose, the WWE Champion, through the table, through our announce table, beating up Ambrose with a bat. Looking, I think, in my opinion, I think Sting is Sting needs the WWE Championship. Without the belt, I don't know. It was the one belt that finally solidified his career. Sting was a lead general in WCW. Well, all over the world. Competed in other promotions, became world champions there. But then now, he finally comes to WWE, and he beats The Undertaker at WrestleMania for the WWE title, but he went on a rampage, a title run that we never seen in Universe Mode. Held the belt for a while, and then, oh wait, what the hell? Look at that WWE championship. That's a new championship belt by Ambrose. So they switched up so Ambrose switched up the title again. That's a beautiful WWE championship belt, though.
Introducing the challenger from every man's nightmare, weighing in at 250 pounds, the man called Sting. And his opponent from Cincinnati, Ohio, weighing in at 225 pounds, he is the WWE champion, Dean.
Dean Ambrose getting a great reception here in Anaheim, California. This is Monday Night Raw's main event of the evening. Our main event of the night will be Brock Lesnar versus The Rock, but tonight will Sting be WWE Champion for a second time, or will Dean Ambrose retain the championship and continue his reign as champion? As the cage lowers down, we get it underway. And the bell has rung. This is not a tornado style. This is one on one. Here we go. Ambrose shot and a chop. Cut over tie up. Sting got Ambrose by the waist. Oh, what a thing of Ambrose. Now got him into a grounded side headlock by Sting. And now Ambrose with a leg lock. Able to turn it around. Able to turn the table. Now, putting pressure around Sting's neck with his legs. And now Ambrose going on to the outside. And now Ambrose, getting a steel chair already. And now wait, Sting. Sting. Rubbing his face onto the cage like if it was a cheese grater.
This is undoubtedly the chance of a lifetime.
Now Sting. Elbow shot to the head there. To Ambrose. Preventing Ambrose from bringing that steel chair in the ring. Wait a minute. Sting on the outside now.
He's still down after that.
Maybe Sting looking to get a breather here. Even though Sting was doing the damage. And now Sting going back inside the ring. And now looking to play some mind games with Ambrose. Iris up off the ropes goes Sting by Dean Ambrose there. And now Ambrose to that back body drop. And now Ambrose going to do damage. Oh, Sting with a shot to the gut there.
No pun intended, of course.
Yeah, he's not
now
gonna
Sting
be comfortable for
has Ambrose. Reverse atomic drop by the former WWE champion. Held the belt for over 9 months. For 9.5 months, Sting held the WWE Championship until losing the belt at Night of Champions in Detroit last month. And a kick to the shoulder there by Sting.
Known on the independent wrestling circuit for taking and dishing out ungodly amounts of punishment.
As Ambrose emerged right where you want him. Oh, nice knee lift there.
Known as the Shield.
Oh, Ambrose emerged as the leader of the Shield.
No, wait. Sting with a nice counter, form to the face. WWE champion Ambrose with a nice jawbreaker. And now Ambrose with a nice neckbreaker to follow it up. Now Ambrose shot to the face in the face buster to follow it up. Ambrose has been a good champion, a standard champion, win the championship and then compete in a lot of places. Ambrose was on the first episode, returning to Universe Mode, the main event, and Ambrose with a powerbomb onto Sting. But looking to do more damage to Sting, and now, Ambrose, headlock driver! Headlock driver by Ambrose. And now Ambrose has Sting. I was looking into the corner. Now Ambrose has Sting. DDT. Tornado DDT from the corner. And now Ambrose doing a lot of work here.
Boy, he just got laid out.
Do over here. Maybe go for an elbow drop. I don't know what he's going for. Maybe he changed his mind. Sting turns oh, the stop. Tie. Oh, wait, Ambrose. That was impressive, wait. I was flipped into the corner by the WWE champion. Ambrose has Sting once again. Tornado style DDT.
Leading the unstoppable force known as the Shield.
Now Ambrose
States
going up to the top. Will he go for the same? Will he go for something he's maybe trying to go for? But no, change his mind again. That's headbutt by Ambrose. But now Sting got Ambrose countered. Nice backflip. That's what to get out of that sidewalk slam predicament. Nice move. But that was the same move that he used to beat Sting at Night of Champions. That neckbreaker with a forearm to the neck. And now Ambrose, wait a minute. Ambrose got him up. Dirty Deeds. Dirty Deeds. And I think he might be busted open. We won't know under the red paint. Hooks the leg. Two count. A kick out by Sting.
A knockdown, drag out brawl.
Sting is still in this match. Ambrose doing whatever it takes to win. Ambrose. Nice elbow. Drop to the leg. Of Sting. Dean Ambrose. I was looking Sting to the corner. Maybe go for that tornado DDT again. But Sting, nice counter. I was shook off the rope to Ambrose. Nice shot to the head there by Sting. Maybe looking to go for a clothesline, but no, but wasn't able to get him completely. Nice stomp to the back of the leg there. Double axe handle to the back of the neck. And now Sting has Ambrose. Face first on the turnbuckle. Snake Eye. Shades of the legendary Undertaker. We have not seen in a while ever since he got attacked by the Wyatt family. And now Sting with a tombstone. Shades of the Undertaker once more. Tombstone power driver. Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. Will it be? And a kick out of two. There's Ambrose.
Well, like they say, Cole, timing is everything. It's going to take more than that to keep
it's
him
been
down
a
tonight.
Clean Hell in a Cell match in the last one he just had with Triple H and Seth Rollins against the Wyatt family. Well, that was a different story. D-A-I-N. And now, oh, Sting. And Sting's in control. Nice elbow to the shoulder there. To the chest there, I should say. And now Sting. I was whipping Ambrose into the corner. And now, oh, Sting! Nice bulldog, I believe. Go for the cover. Hits the leg, shoulders it down. Will it be in a kick out by the WWE champion? And now Sting attacking head and neck area of Ambrose. Sting looking to win back the WWE championship. I mean, the momentum has been shifting, but it has been on Sting's side for a while now. Wait a minute, Sting! Scorpion Death Drop! Can he capitalize? Can he go for the cover? He does. Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. Ambrose in trouble. And a shoulder out by Ambrose.
I can't believe it. He just won't go away.
Oh, my God. Kick out after kick out after kick out. Move after move after move, nothing. Now staying with a suplex onto Dean Ambrose.
Oh, that goes without saying, Cole. The WWE Championship, it's what it's all about.
Ambrose rolled onto the outside, got back inside the ring. Now Dean Ambrose is going to get back into this matchup. Need to get out of the box. Nice back suplex there by Dean Ambrose.
That was awesome. When you're beat up, the last thing you want to have to deal with is this.
And now, oh, Jawbreaker to the right Sting. And now Sting, the Stinger. I was flipping Ambrose into the corner. Stinger splash. The Stinger splash. Will that be enough? Hooks the leg. Shoulders it down. The WWE champion is Sting.
We have a new champion.
The Stinger splash. I believe the same move that won him the championship back in WCW when he defeated Ric Flair. I believe that Great American Bash, Sting, is once again the WWE champion. The Stinger has done it again. Oh my God.
You can bet they're going to be talking about this match for quite some time.
The Stinger is once again the WWE champion. of Monday Night Raw. Now we gotta look forward to Survivor Series. But congratulations to Sting once more here tonight. Coming up next, our main event is the World Heavyweight Championship on the line. The Rock versus Brock Lesnar. It's gonna happen. And now it's time for our main event here at Unforgiven. World Heavyweight Championship for the first time since SummerSlam 2002. The Rock goes one-on-one with Brock. The great one, The Rock, won a battle royale earlier this month, became number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship to face Brock Lesnar. This is the first time since SummerSlam in 2002 in Albany, New York, where The Rock goes one-on-one with Brock Lesnar in the main event of a pay-per-view. Last time they fought was back in SummerSlam. Brock Lesnar was only 25 years of age, and he was able to get the win off of The Rock. That's when The Rock left and did his whole Hollywood shtick. And now it's time for The Rock to maybe get redemption over Brock Lesnar. Can The Rock finally do it? The Rock worked hard to get where he's at now. Can he finally pull off a miracle and become the World Heavyweight Champion? Or will this man retain the championship and continue his title reign? The World Heavyweight Champion, no Paul Heyman needed, Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar, the World Heavyweight Champion, big champion over a month now, within the title back in the main event of SummerSlam of in Madison Square Garden against Randy Orton, and he had a tremendous match against Batista, and then the champions also took Big Show and a lot of people with Sami Zayn recently to Suplex City. Sami Zayn won the U.S. title earlier tonight. This is the second pay-per-view, I believe, that Brock Lesnar is main eventing in Universe Mode. No, this is the third. The first one was back in Backlash in 2000. Back in the beginning of Universe Mode, I meant to say. When he fought John Cena for the WWE Championship. But it all comes down to this. The World Heavyweight Championship. The prestigious title has been around since about the 1900s. Early 1900s, I should say. But here we go. The Rock versus Brock Lesnar. World title on the line. And oh, Lesnar already! German suplex! That's number one. And now, wait a minute, Brock. Brock Lesnar, look at the lock in, a submission hold on The Rock. Brock Lesnar, got the camel clutch on The Rock. Look at it do damage to the, I believe, the neck and the back of Rock. And Lesnar with a powerbomb. And Lesnar, look at the climb up the cage already. Looking to climb up the cage. Off the get-go, and a Rock, dropping Lesnar, bringing him down. And that Rock looking to go to work on over Lesnar. I don't know if Rock studied his tape after, like watching Brock Lesnar's matches and also watching the match he would compete against Brock back in SummerSlam 2002. I would say it's the same thing for Brock, but I don't think that's really necessary because Brock is a well-oiled machine. He's a manager like Paul Heyman, and that's all you need, and you'll be a success. That's Lesnar with a nice counter, and now Lesnar has Rock, and a T-bone suplex, tossing Rock. And now Lesnar, looking to count out the cage already. Again, looking to retain the World Heavyweight Championship. Brock Lesnar. Are we almost at the top? His hands on the top of the cage, though, but Rock! Bringing Lesnar back down to the mat. And he goes for the cover. Remember, there is pinfalls in this match. Cover. Two and a kick out by Brock. They are pinfall and submission, but you can also climb up the cage to win. And maybe, in the Rock's case, win the World Heavyweight Championship. Or Brock's case, retain the World Heavyweight Championship. And now Rock has Brock Lesnar on the Hulk suplex. Now, oh, look at the Rock. Rock got Brock Lesnar in the Dragon Sleeper. Dragon Sleeper submission applied, but I don't think Brock will tap out. I seriously doubt it. And now, oh, look at the Rock. Tossed him up into a Samoa drop. And now Rock looking to climb out the cage himself. Will Rock become World Heavyweight Champion for, I believe, third time? And, oh, no, Lesnar dropping the Rock. Back to the mat. If I can believe, if I even look up The Rock's career, he became World Heavyweight Champion back in 2001 during the Alliance taking over thing. And then he lost the title to Jericho, won it back on Monday Night Raw, won the episode, and then that spy buster by The Rock. Tonight might be his third time winning the world title. Cover. Hooks the leg. Two count. He got him in a kick out by Brock. As The Rock, not able to put Brock Lesnar away. And now wait, oh, Lesnar, by Snapmare. Now Lesnar, ooh, elbow shot. Elbow shot to the chest and the shoulder of Rock. It's like in between. And now Lesnar has Rock. Oh my god, deadlift. Deadlift suplex. Deadlift gut wrench suplex by Brock Lesnar. And now Lesnar. Oh, wait a minute. Lesnar looking to go for a suplex city. The German suplexes, but he does not let go until the third German suplex has been hit. And yes, it does. Third German suplex. He goes for the cover. Shoulders are down. One, two. Get a kick out by Rock. Tremendous main event here. And Unforgiven. A kick to the midsection by Rock. Rock has Brock in the headlock. No way, Brock countered side rushing leg sweep. Critical moment for The Rock and Brock Lesnar. You don't know who's going to walk out world champion in this environment. And Lesnar, Lesnar got him up on the shoulders. Lesnar, F5. The F5. F5 by Lesnar. He goes for the cover. Hooks the leg. Swan, shoulders are down. And that Rock got the shoulder up. A lot of people these days have been kicking out the first F5, man. It took three to beat Batista and The Undertaker back in WrestleMania 30. And now Lesnar. Oh, another deadlift gut-wrench suplex onto Rock. Now Lesnar looking to climb out the cage. Brock Lesnar looking to climb out the cage. Lesnar now looking to start climbing. Rock drops Lesnar. Rock. Drops Lesnar. Rock immediately goes to try to climb up the cage. Rock is halfway there. Rock is halfway there. He needs to get to the top. Can Rock get to the top? Lesnar's up to his feet. The Rock. The Rock is up top. The Rock's up top. The Rock. The Rock has done it. The Rock has done it. The Rock is the World Heavyweight Champion for the third time. We have a new World Heavyweight Champion. The Great One has done it again! Good night, everybody! From Unforgiven here in Anaheim, California. Make sure you hit that thumbs up. Subscribe for more. Follow me on Twitter at Boy123Jim. I thank you guys for the 204 currently subscribers. The Rock has won the World Championship for the first time since 2013. Good night, everybody. Hope you guys enjoy.